Well, let's take a closer look at the entire organization for the Brewers and look at their top prospects. They have three in the MLB.com top 100. Keston Hiura, a second baseman. Corbin Burns, right-handed pitcher. And Brandon Woodruff, right-handed pitcher as well. Let's get a little more information on this with Jonathan Mayo of MLB.com. Tell us about these guys, Jonathan.
Yeah, Hiura is really, really interesting. The bat is exceptionally advanced, one of the most advanced bats in last year's draft class. The only question about him is what position he was going to play. He didn't play the field at all during his junior year because of an elbow injury. Managed to avoid surgery at Instructs at the end of the year. He started to play some more second base. He's getting more and more comfortable. Now they just have to see if it's going to hold up, because that bat, it's the kind of college bat. He's going to hit for average. He's going to get on base. He's going to hit for power. The ball just jumps off of his bat. It's the kind of college bat that could get him to the big leagues in about a year. So it's all going to be about whether or not he can play second base.
Well, those are serious numbers that we put up there. I don't get what level you do 400, 600.
Right.
All right, that's success. You can move on. What about the pitchers?
Yeah, and the pitchers, both of whom could help out in Milwaukee if they need help in that starting rotation. Corbin Burns is their number two prospect, a really good right-hander, good command, average to above average across the board stuff. You can see he made it up to double A in his first full season. So he's going to be knocking on the door. They're hoping that he's going to be in AAA when all is said and done. And Brandon Woodruff, who's at their number three prospect, made it up to Milwaukee last year. Heavy sink to his fastball, gets a lot of ground ball outs. Has some swing and miss stuff as well, but it's really that sinker that he plays off of. And I think you can see both of them as we take a look at Woodruff here. And one of the things that is kind of interesting, BK, with both of them, Corbin Burns, fourth round pick. Brandon Woodruff, 11th round pick. So the scouting staff did a really nice job of identifying maybe not huge top of the rotation arms in the draft, but getting future starting pitchers later on.
Interesting. Give us one other upside guy.
Yeah, I really like the number four guy on their list, Lucas Ursig. I saw him in the fall league out of a smaller school in California. He's a third baseman. He fits the profile really well. I think he's going to hit for average and power. You can see the power already showing up in his first full season last year. I think that he has the chance, and he's going to fill out that body even more with a power maybe plus when all is said and done. He's pretty athletic, and he's going to stick at third base. So he's a guy that I think in maybe another year and a half is a guy that they could count on to be at the hot corner in Milwaukee.
You know, we're going to talk to David Stearns in a moment, but he obviously like went in, right, to get some players now to win now. Still a pretty good system, or has it been cleaned out?
Well, he did such a good job when they hit the rebuild switch of bringing in all this talent that there was plenty to trade from. So, yes, they clearly were thinned out. They're not a top 10 system anymore because of the Yelich trade, but it's a pretty solid to maybe slightly above average system overall.
All right, great stuff. Jonathan, thank you so much.